if the Democrats are what they want people to believe they are, they have no business contracting out public transit or commuter rail. They just don't. Commuter rail is a vital public service. It has no business going through a profiteering multinational company, either an American company or a foreign company. It's a vital public service. It goes right along sanitation, policing service, paramedic service. It should be in the hands of government. It should, as it is in most other American cities. There's written Massachusetts, which is controlled by the Democrats. There's no reason at all under the sun for them to be operating a system that's a commuter rail system predicated upon profiteering. It's ridiculous. And it actually goes against everything the Democrats should be standing for, period. And I think that debate is very much in play right now. We're going through a very similar fight in New York State against a New York State Democratic governor. That's where it is run under the public umbrella. But very similar things are occurring, similar demands, attacks on pensions, attacks on wages. Right at a moment in time where the Democrats are trying to retake the House of Representatives, it's actually quite outrageous. They're allowing workers to be abused simultaneously, telling folks that they're a party of workers, and it's outrageous.
Is this is this exclusively the purview in Massachusetts, anyways? The purview of the governor's office, or is this like, does there have to be a statute that says we're going to allow a Keolis to come in? And has it always been a private entity, or was the commuter rail public before?
So Amtrak ran until 2003, and then there was the outrageously ridiculous decision, a decision against the public good to hand it over to private operators after 2003. And there's a direct correlation to wages and also at least over some period of years to the safety of the railroad itself after it went to privateers after 2003. And to answer your first part of your question, it's directly under control of the state of Massachusetts through the Massachusetts DOT and through the MBTA, which is controlled by the DOT. They could end the contract right now, bring it back in under the public umbrella. The Margaret Thatcherization of the commuter rails at the MBTA does not have to continue.
And when is their contract up? Do you know?
Their contract's up in like 2 years.
All right, interesting.
And it should end. There's really no reason for privateer, profiteering companies to be involved in public transportation, public transport in the United States. It doesn't work. And in fact, overseas, in England itself, much of it has been turned around. It's in the process of being turned around because they just don't go together. The pursuit of profit and public transportation, they're at odds with each other. Either you're providing a public service or you're pursuing profit. They don't go together. They go right against each other.
100%. And it's these decisions need to be made based upon what's going to help these communities again and not put money in their pockets. I just wonder, like, I'm curious because, you know, we've had in Massachusetts, I grew up in Worcester, for much of this century, and going back until to probably Bill Weld, we've had almost exclusive Republican governors. And I wonder how much of this is an opportunity now that we have a Democratic governor in Massachusetts to like apply those principles, like you say, should be second nature for Democrats, as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah, absolutely. I think when the Democrats do things like embrace Republican concepts like privatization of public transit, which is an absolute bona fide public good. When the Democrats behave like Republicans, why would working people vote for the Democrats when they could just vote for the real thing, Republicans? And I think, that has been a phenomenon. Yeah. When working people see Democrats, neoliberal Democrats, behave like Republicans, they vote for Republicans.
Yeah, I think you're right. John Samuelson, really appreciate it. So what's the next thing we should look for? Like, it's really just a question of like this round of negotiations. And then if that doesn't work, and if the Keolis continues to shortchange these workers, you guys start to mobilize a lot more.
Yeah, we're waiting on a response right now from the employer. If the employer delivers a substandard response, you're going to see the TWU International alongside our local We're gonna start organizing the workforce. We're going to continue to organize the workforce. We're going to begin aggressively organizing within the community, within the riders, and we're going to pursue full speed ahead the legal process toward full-blown strike action against the MBTA. And we're going to hold the Democrats accountable.
What can our listeners do to support you guys?
Well, I think as time goes on, as part of this over the next several weeks, there will be reach out from the TWU in and around Boston about elements of support that the community can reach out and let Keolis and the MBTA and perhaps the state of Massachusetts and the political operation of Massachusetts, let them know how dissatisfied they are that Keolis is screwing the workforce on the commuter rails at the MBTA.
John Samuelson, International President of the Transport Workers Union. Thanks so much for your time today. Really appreciate it.
All right. Thanks for having me.
Thanks.